Hello, cloud gurus. This has been a big month for Google Cloud Platform, including new Cloud Deploy and Certificate Manager products, Autoscaling for Bigtable, Assured Workloads for EU, a new generation of cloud functions, and more. I'm Mattias Anderson, and you're watching GCP This Month for February 2022. Let's jump into some quick bites. If you're using Apache Spark to squeeze value from your data, I'm sure it's not because you just really love managing those Spark clusters, right? So then you'll be very happy to hear that Google has just upgraded their Dataproc serverless for Spark offering to generally available. So now you can let Google manage the clusters and tune the infrastructure, and you can focus on coding instead. And as a bonus, there is now also a private preview of Spark through BigQuery, making it even easier to get all that Sparky goodness right close to your data. Now, speaking of managing clusters, Bigtable has also gotten a boost here. Autoscaling for Bigtable is now generally available. There's no point in paying for an over-provisioned Bigtable cluster when your system doesn't need all that capacity, so this is a welcome change to better match your costs to your actual usage. And although Google's blog post does use the rather fun word diurnal no less than 6 times, I'm sure you could just as easily save the 40% they mention if your workload happens to be nocturnal instead. Okay, this announcement is about the new compute-optimized C2D instance family using 3rd-gen AMD EPYC Milan processors. Milan, darling, Milan. You can beef these up with as many as 112 vCPUs and 896 gigabytes of memory. Of course, even though these are compute-optimized CPUs, you can still choose your most appropriate ratio of processors to memory, as usual in Compute Engine. Now, in case you're unfamiliar with it, Assured Workloads is Google's response to Amazon's GovCloud. But instead of being a separate cloud region that meets compliance, Google has a system for workloads to meet compliance in any GCP region within that part of the world. Well, Google's offering of Assured Workloads for the European Union is now generally available. And while this includes data residency, data encryption, and Google personnel, they're still in public preview with a sovereignty controls integration with Cloud External Key Manager that lets you keep your data encryption keys outside of GCP. Now, if you've been following this series for a while, or hey, maybe even if you haven't, then you probably know that I love all things serverless, right? And if you do too, then you'll be happy to hear that Google has just released into public preview their second generation of Cloud Functions. Now, since this new version is built on Cloud Run under the hood, this is really blurring the lines between the serverless compute options. So, we still have the same pay-for-use compute as the first version of Cloud Functions, but now we can also allow for simultaneous processing of multiple requests or events, just like Cloud Run. Of course, make sure that your code can handle concurrent requests before you turn this on, but this could save you a bunch of money if your event handling isn't always pegging the CPU. Also, this second generation lets you run your functions for longer, on beefier instances, pin instances to reduce cold starts, and split traffic between multiple versions. These new cloud functions, they're great! So bad. Now, it's no secret that all websites had better be using HTTPS these days. I mean, not only will normal HTTP connections be marked as not secure in the Chrome address bar, but insecure sites also get buried pages deep in Google searches. So, I'm very glad that Google now has a new serverless certificate manager product in public preview to make it super easy for anyone to get and use TLS certificates on the external HTTPS load balancers that front their GCP-based workloads. You can use 100 certificates for free each month, and it's pay per cert after that. And because these get managed by Google's infrastructure, your clients can super quickly negotiate secure connections with Google's Edge nodes. Super low latency. Oh, and this does also support wildcard certificates. Pretty wild, eh? Okay, I know that joke was terrible. I'm sorry. Another new product is Cloud Deploy, now generally available. As Google notes in their announcement, the operational cost of Kubernetes continuous delivery can be very high. Well, Cloud Deploy aims to take some of that pain away from you with this managed and opinionated continuous delivery service for GKE. Now, if you are using GKE, then you might well find this to be worth the extra $15 per monthly delivery pipeline beyond the first free one. Cloud Deploy is built on Scaffold and includes both easy integrations to GCP management and also many built-in best practices. All right, finally in this segment, I want to let you know about some upcoming events. Coming up on April 6th is the Data Cloud Summit. This will be an online event all about AI, machine learning, analytics, databases, and more. And even better, we now have a date for Google Cloud Next 22. All right. Cloud Next is Google's annual conference packed with all the most exciting GCP announcements. So make sure to block off October 11th through the 13th. And if you're hoping against hope, like I am, that this might wind up being an in-person event this year, then be sure to also reserve some extra time for travel to and from San Francisco. I hope to see you there. All right, now let's dig into this month's gem of an announcement. Actually, it's kind of a bunch of related goodness. To start off with, the Google Developer Relations team has been hard at work, and they have made a massive update to the Google Cloud Developer Cheat Sheet. Now, I'm sure you're already familiar with this amazing tool if you've taken some of my courses on Google Cloud, but if you haven't, then that's all right. You're one of today's lucky 10,000 or so, because this thing is awesome. This is also known as Google Cloud Products in 4 words or less. Yeah. And this is a part of its beauty. 4 judiciously chosen words to give you a good feel for what any particular GCP product does. Every product is included. It's comprehensive. The printable poster version is still my favorite, but a key benefit of the new interactive version is that every product card links you straight to the documentation so that you can dig into that thing with a few more than just the 4 words. And the list view, selectable at the top, has the same comfortable at-a-glance feel of the poster. And not only have we gotten a massive update to this immensely valuable tool, it looks like we're going to be getting a lot faster updates in the future too. Priyanka Vergadia regularly puts out great content about Google Cloud, and since she has now taken over maintenance of this tool, its future is looking very bright. But wait, there's more! They've also just released a new diagramming tool for GCP architectures. And by itself, this might not seem so exciting, but the coolness is in the integrations. First, the components for your diagram are connected with the cheat sheet to help both with the picking and understanding them. Next, you can bootstrap your diagrams from a library of reference architectures. But not only that, some of these architecture examples are set up so you can very easily deploy them into your project to play around with them. Pretty nice, eh? Well, this month's announcements really were a big deal, but I'd be remiss if I didn't also tell you about the big deal we're currently running at A-Cloud Guru to help you learn cloud more deeply and efficiently. We're still offering our always free and no credit card required plan as well, but we're making our free trial even sweeter by significantly dropping the price of the annual membership if you sign up before March 7th. I tell you how much you can save, but then I'd just make people jealous if they watch this video after the deadline. So check it out for yourself. But in any case, I hope that you can have a really awesome upcoming month. Stay safe, take care of those around you, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus. Milan, darling, Milan. Milan, darling, Milan. Milan, darling, Milan.